I want to take you through this, the program. It was supposed to start at 2 with registration, and it's going on. At 2:30, we shall have an opening prayer led by our chaplain, Reverend Ime Musite. At 2:35, we shall welcome our Vice Chancellor to give us welcome remarks. At 10:03, we shall introduce, or we shall have the introduction of the speaker by the Chair Council. Who will be the Chair Council? And all these will be coordinated together. And then we shall invite the presenter. And at this point, I want to welcome the presenter, Mr. John Makoha, the County Director of Arts Foundation. Our partners, you're welcome. Then we have a reflection and discussion by Dr. Florence Nakaiwa, the Deputy Executive Secretary, Learning Resource Mobilization and Management, the forum, that is regional forum for the regional university forum. And then the two will be coordinated by Professor Gashu Matunda. Then at 4:45, or 4:45, we shall invite our Chancellor, the Right Reverend Dr. Fred Sheldon, to give us closing remarks and prayer. And then together, we shall join on a table for some refreshment. I hope we have the program with us. At this juncture, I want to request the chaplain to get ready, because we have very few minutes. We have very few minutes to 2:30. So get ready to take us on through the prayer. Meanwhile, we shall be organizing
Beloved of God, can I request you that you stand and pray? Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we bless you for this day. We thank you so much that you've given us an opportunity to come together as your children, above all, O King of Glory, to come to learn from you. For you tell us in your word that your children are perishing just because of lack of knowledge. We have come to this fountain to learn from you. We pray that you teach us. Teach us through your own servants. Teach us through the academicians that you have set apart to impact this world. We have come for a public lecture. How I pray, O God, that we will show from this time and we will go filled of your spirit and of your power of knowledge. Father, King of Glory, in Isaiah chapter 11, verse 2, you tell us of the seven spirits of God. And one of the spirits is a spirit of knowledge, and a spirit of wisdom, and a spirit of understanding. We pray, O King of Glory, that as we learn to the feet of your children whom you bestowed your spirit of understanding upon, may we, O God, hear from you and learn from you and go equipped, because when you invite people, you equip them, you anoint them, and therefore send them. Pray that we will be equipped, O King of Glory, this evening. And as we will go anointed of your spirit to do your work. Bless us, O God. Pray that you speak through your servants, Mr. John Makoha, through Dr. Flores, and through all the discussants, that we will hear you speak to us and we will understand you, so that this nation will not only produce, but it will go agribusiness, it will go entrepreneurship, and it will embrace technology. And we will go out of this room to go and impact others, for we will have shot from your own heavenly kingdom and heavenly knowledge. Be with us and show us your mercy. In your name, Jesus Christ, we pray and trust.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Chaplain. I once again want to welcome you to this public lecture. And the theme is agribusiness, technoprenueurship, and institutional and national development. And we are blessed to have well-informed and well-versed discussants on this topic, whom we shall hear. And at this point, I want to invite the Vice Chancellor to give us welcome remarks.
Thank you, MC. I'm requesting Public Relations Officer Rose. May you come in. Before I say my remarks, we must first welcome you. And I take the honor, our guest of honor, and most importantly, the keynote speaker, Mr. Makoa, a county representative of SCAL, Addis. And actually, they told me you are also the regional coordinator. So he's here in two capacities, the regional coordinator and county coordinator. You are most welcome. This is a very big club. I take the honor to recognize and welcome Professor Adipara Ekwamu, represented here. Professor Adipara Ekwamu is the executive director of the forum and is represented here by Dr. Florence Nakayua, who is the deputy executive director. May you stand for the recognition and welcome you. You are welcome to me. I also know her in another capacity. This lady is the one who was heading planning unit of McGill University. So whatever you see in McGill University, all the plans, the space, infrastructure development, she's the master planner behind it. Actually, we asked her, Forrest, you have left McGill, what next? So she's a pathfinder, and after I said, when you come, you must say something about planning. Dr. Forrest, we are honored that you are here. I take the honor to welcome our chancellor, Right Reverend Dr. Fred Shebel-Mosigo. He's known, but I'm sure some of you may not know him. Yes. And the team from the diocese. I'm requesting you to stand. Yes. We have Board of Trustees. Actually, when Bishop is here, the owners are here of the university. Bishop Shep University is because of our diocese. Therefore, we have the owners, whom we call Board of Trustees. By the way, we are getting the charter. That's when I got it clear. They asked the question when we are trying to fidget, when National Council came to visit, they said, the owners must come out clearly. So everyone who can challenge BSU, you must challenge the owners first. That's what was put in the charter. The owners of the diocese, represented here by Bishop and the team, I'm requesting Canon Lydia Kajira to stand. The owners, if you are there, if you are part of the owners, you will stand. Bishop, I know you are very discreet, but there is no way. You people know that you chair what they call Board of Trustees. So he's here as the bishop, as the chancellor, but also the chairperson of Board of Trustees. And the diocese. And members have seen Reverend Canon with a GUI. Where are you? He's a senior citizen who normally comes to the university. Who is the one here? This one is well known in the university. And we really appreciate you so much. We have Army Commander, 2nd Division. Makenge is here with us. But that's not all. We have trained many of the people. Today I was at IOV. I was in this. Someone said, you know what? I'm an alumni of what? Of Bishop Stuart University. We have trained many of your staff, police, army, and we are requesting that now we are telling them come now for masters and PhDs, which is great. So thank you very much for coming and for giving us services. And I want to report when your team comes around, they are all very active. Citizen, Professor Nganwa Baguma. You don't know, maybe, because he was living in South Africa. One thing that is good, I'm requesting you to stand again. People want to know you. You are one of these key persons you have in this country, but when he's around, you see a low profile man, but he's a high profile gentleman. Why? He started medical school. Maybe we'll say it later. When there is the reactions. He started a medical school from scratch in South Africa. So when he was coming, they recognized him. I attended a function in the parliament of South Africa. Just that, you know, to enter in the books of parliament, I'm sure you know what it means. Not everybody can access. Moreover, as a black, a Ghanaian, so he's here as a man of great honor. I wish government can give him honor. Yes. And of course, you know, we have a lot in common. When it comes to Bishop Stuart University, we have Ngana Brock, even so many things. So we really appreciate it. I want to recognize MAST, Marine Universal Science and Technology. The team that is here, may you really stand for recognition. Our neighbors, those ones who normally work very closely. MAST, please, I have seen some other members of MAST. Yes, MAST, please, I'm going to stand here. I have to introduce you. The gentleman there, the name, is an auditor of MAST. But he's also our auditor. He's an actual part of the Council of BSU. He's the auditor of BSU. He sits on the committee of audit, Council Audit Committee of BSU. And normally, MAST, when we have recruitments, we go there, get the human resource, get the IT experts. We are really good neighbors. We really appreciate you so much. Thank you so much. There is Dr. Kasim. Dr. Kasim, you have heard of African Centers of Excellency. Actually, that is for Dr. Florence Naka. You are not very well, and our county representative, I want to let you know that Reforum and African Centers of Excellency, I think it is Reforum that started the move. Then, taken to the University Council of East Africa. So MAST has one of the 24 African Centers of Excellence, isn't it, Kasim? And one is headed by Mbarara University of Science and Technology of Farm Biotrack. Farm Biotrack, this one is about development of indigenous knowledge, traditional medicines, developing them into proper medicines, including food. So the lady whom you see, this is quite ready. And I've known her for many years. She's heading one of the
Chair Innovation and Business Management.
Exactly. And Bishop Stuart University, we are partners. I was part of the team that developed the project. So we are partners. For us, we have plans to be coming for ecotourism. And that's not all. We have a garden now of medicinal plants with Mbazadri. That is the stock farm, what was formerly stock farm. We have there 5 acres of medicinal plants. We are actually going to acquire more through a project which was sponsored by World Bank to BSU. Now, actually, to give birth to be partners with them. So you are most welcome and we appreciate you. Avis, I know the council representative is here, the general coordinator, but there is a team from Avis already. She coordinates Avis here. When you see her, she comes in her offices, we have projects with Avis. By the way, I have not said this. Our guest of honor tomorrow for our graduation is the ambassador of the Kingdom of Netherlands. And they are the sponsor, actually they are the owners of Avis Sky. Why the BSU? It is because of our partnerships. And it is this team. It is Helen. Helen and Amon. Where is Amon? Amon is coming.
In the field.
Amon is in the field. They are the ones who are behind this. And when the partnership started, because of our strong agriculture partnerships with Israel, agribusiness, we had to get it. We have trained so far all 16 business experts. We have business coaches. If you come for our graduation tomorrow, you find we are going to be selling products from our incubation. Right now, we are at the stage of developing some of them actually this time there to take them into the market. I can assure you, public lecture, we shall be selling new products from BSU. Just that UNPS number. So Helen, thank you very much for being there for us. But maybe I should say this, you're also a student. When she came in and she saw the program, she got attracted to the university. Alice first started, it's not that she brought Alice when she said I must do one. One of the programs she's doing is climate change.
Climate, Master of Science
in
Climate Change and Food Security.
Very good. What we are promoting at the university. And I'm sure that's what the Netherlands government is promoting, that's what ACT is promoting, and I believe we are all in the same track. And when I say this, there is a coordinator in the Stuart University, Madame Deborah. She should stand for being the one behind all exhibitions that you see what the Stuart University goes. She's the one in charge. Even in the farm, she's the one in charge. And right now, she's a student of PhD in Guru University, sponsored by the forum. Everyone is not alone. There is weekly.